The third common question that can be asked by the non-Muslim is that you Muslims, you subjugate the woman by keeping her in the veil. You know, you keep her in the hijab, in the parda, in the veil, and you subjugate her. You look down upon her by keeping in the veil. In fact, Islam is the first religion which gave rights to the woman. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the major benefactor who uplifted the woman. And if you analyze the history of how women were treated in the previous civilizations, for example, if you read the history of Babylonia, the Babylonian civilization, there, if a man murdered a woman, instead of the man punished, the wife of the man was punished. If you read the history of the Greek civilization, the Greeks, they called the woman as the Pandora. Pandora was the name given, as a sign of misfortune. And women in the Greek civilization, she was used only for sex and pleasure. If you read the history of the Roman civilization, there were a lot of nudity and promiscuity amongst the women, and the women were ill-treated. In the Egyptian civilization, the women were considered as the sign of the devil. In the Arab civilization before the Quran was revealed, the moment a female used to be born, very often she was put to death. Alhamdulillah, after the revelation of the glorious Quran, this evil practice had discontinued in Arabia. Islam, as I said, is the first religion which uplifted the woman. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the major benefactor. Now, after Islam has given equal rights to the woman, Islam says it is the duty of the woman to maintain the level of modesty. Uplifted the woman, it's their duty to maintain it. And people talk about the hijab, about the veil, you know, the hijab in Islam, etc. And always talk about the hijab of the woman, hijab of the woman. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the glorious Quran, first speaks about the hijab for the man and then of the woman. If you read the Quran, Quran says in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 30, that say to the believing man that he should lower his gaze and guard his modesty. That whenever a man looks at a woman and any brazen thought comes in his mind, any unashamed thought comes in his mind, he should lower his gaze. First, the Quran mentions the hijab of the male. There was once a friend of mine, who was a Muslim, who was staring at a girl for a long time. So I told him, brother, what are you doing? It's not allowed in Islam. So he told me, brother, our beloved Prophet said that the first glance is allowed. I have not yet completed half my glance. What did the Prophet mean when he said that the first glance is allowed? The Prophet didn't mean that you can look at a woman and without blinking look at her for 10 minutes and then say, you know that my glance is not complete. What the Prophet meant that if you look at a woman unintentionally, don't again look at her intentionally and stare at her with an unashamed eye. That doesn't mean you can look at a woman and feast at her for a long time. That's what the Prophet meant. Intentionally don't look at her. Again, don't feast on her beauty, etc. The next verse of the glorious Quran, Surah Nur chapter 24, verse number 31, speaks about the hijab for the woman. It says, say to the believing woman that she should lower her gaze and guard her modesty and display not her beauty except what appears ordinarily of, and draw her veil, a head covering over the bosom, except in front of her husband, her father, her son, and a big list of mahram, the close relatives who she can't marry is given. Among these people, she can relax her hijab. Otherwise, amongst all the other people, she should maintain the hijab. And the criteria for hijab is given in the glorious Quran, as well as the Sahih Hadith, that basically there are six criteria. The first is the extent which differs between the man and the woman. For the man, it's from the navel to the knee. For the woman, the complete body should be covered. The only part that can be seen are the face and the hands up to the wrist. Some scholars say that even this should be covered. But the minimum is that the complete body should be covered except the face and the hands up to the wrist. The remaining five criteria are the same for the man and the woman. The second is the clothes they wear, it should not be so tight that it reveals the figure. The third is it should not be transparent so that you can see through. Fourth, it should not be so glamorous that it attracts the opposite sex. Fifth, it should not resemble that of the unbeliever. You cannot wear clothes that resemble, which are signs, which are identity of unbelievers, like cross, sign of Christianity, Om, sign of Hinduism. And the last is, you should not wear clothes that which resemble the opposite sex. You know, you have in the Western country, people wearing one earring, you know? Men wearing one earring. It has certain indication, one earring. All this is not allowed in Islam. And The reason for hijab for the woman has been described in the glorious Quran in Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 59, which says, O Prophet, tell your wives and the believing women that when they go abroad, they should put on the cloak so that they shall be recognized and it will prevent them from being molested. The Quran says that hijab has been prescribed for the women so that they shall be recognized and it will prevent them from being molested. I want to ask you a question. Let's suppose there are two sisters who are twins and who are equally beautiful, they're very beautiful, and they're walking down the streets of Singapore. One is wearing the Islamic hijab, complete body covered, except the face and the hands up to the wrist. And the second sister, she's wearing the Western clothes, the skirt or the mini. And when they're walking down the streets of Singapore, around the corner, there is a hooligan. There's a ruffian who's waiting for a catch, who's waiting to tease a girl. I'm asking a question, which girl will he tease? Will he tease the girl wearing the Islamic hijab, or will he tease the girl wearing the skirt or the mini? Which girl will he tease? Which one will he tease? The one wearing the skirt of the mini, but natural. So Quran rightly says that hijab has been prescribed so that it will prevent them from being molested. You know, the Western world, they talk about women's liberalization. The Western talk of women's liberalization is nothing but a disguised form of exploitation of her body, of deprivation of honor and degradation of her soul. The Western society, claiming to uplift the woman, have actually degraded her to the status of a concubine, of a mistress, of society butterflies, which are mere tools in the hands of sex marketers and pleasure seekers, which are hidden behind the colorful screen of art and culture. Islam has uplifted the woman. And I said, it's their duty to maintain their status. That's the reason that Islam prescribes hijab to maintain the modesty of the woman, not to degrade or to subjugate her.